be the one nurtured by the holy prophet's hand. Ali, the chosen one, he gifted on a ship of a eternal land. Ali, brother of Nabi, the one nurtured by the holy prophet's hand. Ali, the chosen one, he gifted on a ship of a eternal land. Almighty, so pleased with his creation, with such ease did he pass all tribulations. Born in praise, in days of great ignorance, with his speech so sweet, peak of eloquence. لو أنت يا علي لم يعرف المؤمنون بعدي. لو أنت يا علي لم يعرف المؤمنون بعدي.
أضم الله أجورنا وأجوركم بمصاب سيدي ومولاي علي بن أبي طالب. Our condolences go to the Imam of our time and to the whole Muslim world on the martyrdom and the strike of Asadullah al-Ghalib, the Lion of God, Ali, son of Abu Talib. Peace and blessings be upon him. This is the first night of the injury of our master Amir al-Mu'mineen. This time around 1,400 years ago is a time where the poison is flowing through the blood of our master, which means he only has one more day left on this earth, then we will all be orphans. This heart-wrenching night, this heartbreaking moment where Sayyida Zainab has to look towards her father in such a state, where Imam al-Hassan, Imam al-Hussein, Abu Fadl have to look at their father in such a state, when he is the one who took down the door of Khaybar. He is the one, he's the conqueror of Siffin. And to see him in such a state, this is our father, and we have lost him by the treacherous and poisonous sword of the cursed Ibn Muljim. May Allah remove his mercy from him. First of all, Assalamu alaikum, dear viewers, wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Inshallah, through this show, we'll be showing you the atmosphere here in Karbala al-Muqaddasa, the holy city of Karbala, and in the holy city of Najaf, where Amir al-Mu'mineen is buried. And inshallah, we will go through some of the masa'ib and look at some of the atmosphere that is happening in these holy cities. As you can hear in the background, brothers and sisters, the A'mal are happening of Layal al-Qadr, the night of power. And if you can hear, he's at the section where he shouts, Bi'aliyyan bi'ali, for the sake of Amir al-Mu'mineen, the one whose head was struck on this day. It was not only the head of Amir al-Mu'mineen that was struck, it was the Quran that was struck, it was Islam that was struck. And you can see the tears in people's eyes as the A'mal are being recited. You can see the pain and the agony in their heart as they call out, Bi'aliyyan bi'ali, for the sake of Amir al-Mu'mineen, our father. We want our hajat to be answered. And for the majority, they just pray that they are blessed with the opportunity to mourn and to beat their chest and shed their tears for Amir al-Mu'mineen. For now, brothers and sisters, we have the poet of the Ahlul Bayt and the reciter of the Ahlul Bayt, Sayyid Mahdi Abidi, on the line. Assalamu alaikum, dear brother.
Wa alaikum as-salam, dear brother. How are you?
Alhamdulillah, I am well. Thank you for asking. What about yourself, brother?
Alhamdulillah, everything
going well with the Ahlul Bayt. Alhamdulillah, wa shukr, dear brother. Our condolences to you and to the whole world on the martyrdom of our master, Amir al-Mu'mineen. And inshallah, as a reciter, as a poet of the Ahl al-Bayt, will bless us with some words in honor of this tragic event.
Thank you, brother. Inshallah, everyone spends the night worshipping and spends the night lamenting and doing matam for our Amir al-Mu'mineen.
Yes, yes. As you can see on the screen also, the Zawar have poured into not only Karbala, but Najaf also to revive the nights of power and also revive the rituals of the Ahl al-Bayt in mourning of Amir al-Mu'mineen. The majalis are everywhere. There's mawakibs everywhere. The atmosphere is very vibrant. And during the next few nights, inshallah, you'll see the rise in the atmosphere. Then straight after the martyrdom, inshallah, like from my experience, the city will just be empty. You'll see nothing but peace straight after the martyrdom, the day of the Shahada of Amir al-Mu'mineen. There'll be nothing but quiet. The world will go dead after the martyrdom of Amir al-Mu'mineen. And as you can see on your screens also, and dear brother, the atmosphere in Najaf also, the Zawar are building up, waiting to hear that Fajr Adhan, the Adhan of Allahu Akbar, where the strike of Amir al-Mu'mineen will happen. And also you can see they are reciting Dua Jawshan al-Kabir.
MashaAllah, this is all from the benefit for us Ahl al-Bayt loving people, the Shias of Imam Ali. We are spreading all across the world, not only in Iraq, not only in Iran, not only in Syria, everywhere we are spreading. And everywhere we are spreading the message of the Ahl al-Bayt and lamenting the Ahl al-Bayt.
Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, brother. You know, it is our duty, especially in the West, for those of us that are living in the West, to propagate the message of the Ahlul Bayt through the rituals and through the akhlaq of the Ahlul Bayt, through reciting poetry as yourself you do, Sayyid, and through writing poetry also. So everyone has to use their talent and their skill to propagate and promote the message of the Ahlul Bayt. And inshallah, brother Sayyidina, the platform is yours, inshallah, to recite and bless us with some poetry.
Thank you, brother. I have a small latmiya, a small noha for Imam Ali alayhim salam. In this, there is also a message to the enemies of the Shia Islam, enemies takfiri Daesh. There is also a message in this, and inshallah, we can all benefit from it.
Inshallah.
لبيك يا علي لبيك يا علي لبيك يا علي يا مرتضى لبيك يا علي لبيك يا علي لبيك يا علي يا مرتضى for he is salvation the cure to our nation, killed during prostration, killed for a soul. Your Haydar, we call you to protect us and to guide the enemy back, destroy all harm. We are the ones to fight your enemy. Your lovers are all around the field. Namaz Fajr in Karbala. Namaz Dhuhr in Samarra. Namaz Asr in Sha'Allah. In Baghi and Mosque of Aqsa. لبيك يا علي لبيك يا علي لبيك يا علي يا مرتضى لبيك يا علي لبيك يا علي لبيك يا علي يا مرتضى لك عدت حيدر بحرين انت الشوار Everywhere Karbala and Ashura Zari and the world, small boys and little girls, the smallest coffins are the heaviest. You think you can kill us, oh Takfiri, we can deceive you all with our Takfiri. Oh Takfiri, we're Haydari, on the right path, we're Hussaini. لبيك يا حسين لبيك يا حسين لبيك يا حسين يا صار الله لبيك يا حسين لبيك يا حسين لبيك يا حسين يا صار الله. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
أحسنت سيد مهدي فضات.
Thank you there, brother, for this recitation. I'm grateful.
Thank you very much, brother. Please do not forget us in your dua. Inshallah, we'll be together with you reciting Bain al-Haramain in the near future, inshallah.
Inshallah, brother.
Jazakallah khair al-jaza. Thank you very much. Dear viewers, as you have it, that was Sayyid Mehdi Abidi from the UK reciting, and indeed, Labbaik Ya Ali Ya Murtada, our master, the prince of the believers, on the days of his martyrdom, we recite Labbaik Ya Ali and Labbaik Ya Ali always. And we must not forget that there is no day like Aba Abdullah's day, as the Imam says in narrations, La Yawm Kiyomaka Aba Abdullah, and there is only one Ashura. But at the same time, we must revive all the rituals of the Ahlul Bayt and revive all the masa'ib of the Ahlul Bayt. And as you can see on the screen now, dear brothers and sisters, the different shots of the atmosphere here in Karbala and in Najaf, you can see the Zawar are filling up. And as mentioned earlier, in Najaf, there's Dua Joshan al-Kabir being recited as it is Laylatul Qadr here in Karbala for some maraji, and for some it was yesterday. So Laylatul Qadr is being performed right now in the shrines, which means tonight at the time of Fajr, that is the peak of Aza, the peak of the love shown for the Ahlul Bayt. When he shouts Allahu Akbar, that is when the Aza will begin. And when he shouts Ashhadu Anna Aliyan Waliyullah, that is when the peak of the Aza rises, with the Zawar and the lovers of the Ahlul Bayt shouting Tahaddamat Wallah Arkan al-Huda, the pillars of light, the pillars of Islam have been destroyed, as was heard in the skies at the moment of the strike of Amir al-Mu'mineen. Tahaddamat Wallah Arkan al-Huda. And the lovers of the Ahlul Bayt will pour into the shrine of Ali ibn Abi Talib and into the shrine of Imam al-Husayn, calling out Tahaddamat Wallah Arkan al-Huda, calling out Haydar, beating their chest, beating their head in honor for Amir al-Mu'mineen, crying, pouring their heart out to our master and in honor of our master. Brothers and sisters, if you use these next few moments just to appreciate and to feel yourself inside the shrine of Amir al-Mu'mineen, inside the shrine of Abu Fadl, Bain al-Haramain, and feel yourself within the vicinity of the shrine, and inshallah, you can ask for your hajat, and we will return shortly, inshallah, with another phone call and more about the shahada of Amir al-Mu'mineen.
With arrogance. mighty yes rival crumble, and that's why the skies cried no youth like Ali. لو أنت يا علي لم يعرف المؤمن ولا بعدي. لو أنت يا علي لم يعرف المؤمن ولا بعدي. لو أنت يا علي لم يعرف المؤمن ولا بعدي. It hurts me deeply knowing the suffering you had to go through.
Dear viewers, I hope that you looking at the shrines, gazing upon the shrines, and having the aza played in the background quenched your heart. At this heart-rending moment here in Karbala, one can't help but shed tears for the masa'ib of Amir al-Mu'mineen, peace and blessings be upon him. Inshallah, we will be joined shortly by Dr. Shabir Tijani, a great reciter and a great servant of the Ahlul Bayt. Inshallah, he will bless us with a few words in honor of Amir al-Mu'mineen. Inshallah, will help us shed tears for the masa'ib of Amir al-Mu'mineen. And we pray that all the servants of Imam al-Hussein and the servants of Amir al-Mu'mineen are blessed, inshallah. And as I mentioned earlier also, when I was walking around the city of Karbala, every house, every Husayniyah was opened in aza, welcoming the zuwar into the majlis of aza, beating their chests, reciting eulogies and qasidas for Amir al-Mu'mineen in honor of this tragic event and tragic occasion. And inshallah, it will be going on throughout the night. And as mentioned again, until Fajr, this is all a build-up until the time of Fajr, where the peak of Aza will take place. And after Fajr, as soon as the sun rises, you'll see the calm happen again. You'll see everyone in that state of stillness, as if they have lost someone. It's not just as if, it is the fact that they have lost someone great to them. We say bi abi anta wa ummi ya Aba Abdullah to Imam al-Hussein, but what of Amir al-Mu'mineen? He has more authority over me than I have over myself. He's closer to me than my family is, than anyone is. He's closer to me than any loved one, and I have lost a loved one, Amir al-Mu'mineen. We have all lost our father, Amir al-Mu'mineen. And as you can see also, the two flags of the sons of Amir al-Mu'mineen, Abi Abdullah al-Hussein and Abu Fadl al-Abbas, the flags of the sons of the one who was martyred. Just think about their situation and how they were feeling on that night where Amir al-Mu'mineen was struck. Imagine that walk that they had with Amir al-Mu'mineen from Masjid al-Kufa to his house. That is a distance of 500 meters. A walk of 500 meters. What was going through their mind as they were walking back to the house? What would they tell Sayyidah Zainab? What would they tell Umm al-Masa'ib? That her father has been struck? That she has been orphaned? It's hard enough what's happened to her on the day of the door, the burning of the door, but now she comes home to see her father drenched in his own blood, poisoned blood by the sword of Ibn Muljim. May Allah remove his mercy from him. What would they tell her when they know that later in her life she will see her brother going through the greatest of tragedies here in Karbala? Inshallah, now we are joined by Dr. Shabir Tijani, a great servant and a reciter of the Ahlul Bayt. Salamun alaykum, Doctor.
Wa alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, Brother Hussein. How are you?
Alhamdulillah, I am doing very well here in the land of Karbala. Hope you're doing well yourself.
Alhamdulillah, very well. Just want to extend my condolences to yourself, the viewers, and of course our awaited Imam, Imam Mahdi. May Allah hasten his reappearance on these days which mark the martyrdom of Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam.
Yes, of course. And you can hear the aza and the drums in the background, I assume, brother Dr. Shabir. They are out in Mawakib to moon the Shahada of Amir al-Mu'mineen. As I mentioned earlier as well, the aza is everywhere and it's just building up until the time of Fajr. And
absolutely. I can imagine, especially there in the Holy Lands in Karbala and Najaf and also in Kufa, it must be a very emotional time where everyone's remembering and mourning and commemorating this great loss.
Alhamdulillah. And of course, with the blessing of servants of Imam Hussein and Amir al-Mu'mineen like yourself, reciting eulogies to bring the tears of the lovers of the Ahlul Bayt, I beg you, Doctor, I urge you to recite us a few lines to, inshallah, bring tears down in our eyes, inshallah, on this tragic occasion.
Inshallah, if we start with the salawat,
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad.
Inshallah, this poem, I'm only going to recite a few verses, maybe three or four verses. We wrote in the memory of Ali ibn Abi Talib, alayhi salam, and it's just outlining his qualities and his merits. It's in a few languages. Well, I'll recite a couple of verses in English and a couple of verses in Urdu, inshallah.
Inshallah, the platform is yours, brother.
You couldn't hear an orphan's cry, nor see a tear in their eye. You'd give them food whilst in disguise, for this is how you spent your night. Nab'un fil Qur'ani يعرفك القاصي والداني وللجفام مطالب علي بن أبي طالب أسد الله الغالب غالب على كل غالب يا مظهر العجائب علي بن أبي طالب هو تجاب مولا طبعا سجده میں تھا وہ روزدار سر ہو گیا تھا خون بار رونے لگے تھے سوگوار كنت لدین سلاما صرت اخن ثم إماما وللقرآن مواظب علي بن أبي طالب أسد الله الغالب غالب على كل غالب يا مظهر العجائب علي بن أبي طالب A lion in the battlefield protected the prophet like a shield. If enemies stood up for the king, it is as though their fate was sealed. Sana'a Saiful Bari خارق ضربتهم من ناري بذلف قار الضارب علي بن أبي طالب أسد الله الغالب غالب على كل غالب يا مظهر العجائب علي بن أبي طالب تجانهم کو ہے خبر مشکل کبھی آئے اگر مشکل خوشا کا سایہ ہے شبیر کے غم خوار رفیدك على وشك النفاذ الرجاء فحل خطك
بارنسك I believe the line has been cut. Unfortunately, the line has been cut with such a beautiful recitation, heart-rending recitation from Dr. Shabir Al-Tijani. Unfortunately, the line was cut, and I apologize to Dr. for what just happened. Inshallah, he'll join us in the near future here in the land of Karbala, where we can mourn together here in Karbala, face to face, inshallah. And, you know, alhamdulillah, it's amazing to know that these reciters all over the world are reviving the rituals around the world and doing majalis not just in the Holy Lands, but all over the world, in the UK, all over the cities, in London, in Birmingham, in Bradford, in Manchester, in Leicester, in the US, in many of the states, in Canada, many of the states, in Australia, everywhere in the world, there's majalis being upheld for the Musa'ib of Amir al-Mu'mineen. And I'd like to thank both Dr. Shabir Tejani and Sayyid Mehdi Abidi for the beautiful recitations and the amazing input on this tragic occasion and this heart-wrenching moment. That is a time where the blood is flowing through, the poison is flowing through the blood of our master, the Prince of Believers. And as we are coming towards the near end of our show, I'd like to remind the viewers that the atmosphere is something that's important. It's not just something we say, you know, it's not something that people create, but no, it is important. I urge that when you do majalis, to focus on creating that atmosphere, not for yourself, but to bring people in, those who might not be so much into majalis, but it will encourage them to come more, encourage them to contribute to the majalis more. As many great groups I know in London are doing, they are creating the majalis atmosphere through the aza, through the way they set up the hall, through the sound they prepare. And that is something we must all work towards, inshallah, to encourage more people to come to the majalis. And as we come to the end of our show, I'd like to end by sending our condolences to the Imam of our time and to the whole Muslim world on the martyrdom of his grandfather, Amir al-Mu'mineen, and our father of orphans, Imam Ali alayhi salam. I'd like to leave you with footage of Najaf and Karbala and the atmosphere that's happening. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. رحمی نداره زخمای زیاد رو دلم میذاره درد دل هامو من میگم با دل شاه عمری تو دلم دارم حسرت و آه غیر رفتن برای من نمونده راه درد دل هامو من میگم با دل شاه عمری تو دلم دارم حسرت و آه غیر رفتن برای من نمونده راه از جگرم خونی سرم آه از جگرم خونی سرم داره می سوزه چشمای ترم
آتیش زدن و ریختن ببرن.